I2C lets you connect many devices with low pin count, and with StemmaQT, you can even chain boards, but it can hit limits when operating over distances of a meter plus. Increasing a wire's length also increases its capacitance, which can cause your waveform to rise slowly, and inductance, which can add ringing to the signal. So sending I2C lines over multiple meters may leave your signals looking pretty rough. If long distance is a must, you can try lowering the clock speed to, say, 50 or 10 kHz, which can give the bus extra time to propagate over long wires. I2C has no minimum clock speed, so worth a try? Or you can maintain speed with support hardware, like the LTC4311 Active Terminator. This chip injects a current boost whenever it senses the bus's pull-up resistors in use, dramatically improving rise time for each bit of data.